In our first lesson about the five-step method, I'm going to show you all the steps with this photo as an example. I shot it on an evening walk with a compact camera in a little village in Spain. And because that compact camera has a relatively small sensor and the light was a little dim, I started by bringing down the noise. I select the third tab, and in noise reduction, I drag the luminance slider up to 38. The sliders for color noise are the default values when you use a RAW file. Now I go back to my basic tab, and because the nightlight tricked my camera's meter to overexpose a little bit, I'm going to drag the exposure slider back a little. I'm going to up the contrast, and also the highlights can do with a little boost. The shadows can go down a bit, mainly because I want to dim the entrance behind the little girl a bit. The whites go up, and I leave the blacks as they are. Also in this photo, I'm going to leave the clarity slider alone, but I'm going to up the vibrance and the saturation to about a plus 20 value. I'm satisfied with my RAW conversion now, and I'm going to open the image. The next step of my five-step process is about composition, and in this case, I want to straighten things up. So I'm going into the crop tool. In the toolbar options, I select the straighten tool, and I'm going to drag a little line in that background that has to be straight. Now I only have to press the enter key. If I now drag a guide from my left ruler, then you can see that still the photo isn't exactly straight. So with Command or Control A, I select the whole picture, follow that by Command or Control T to get in transformation mode, and here I choose perspective. I now drag the bottom left corner outside until the vertical line is okay. I press enter when that's the case. Command or Control D deselects my selection, and when going into the view menu, I can deselect my guide. This concludes the second step. And now in the third step, I'm going to concentrate on the colors. There's not much that I would like to do to the colors in this image, but some local adjustments may be just fine. I'm going to select an adjustment layer for hue saturation. Here I'm going to drag the overall saturation up a little to give me some more saturated colors. And I'm going to select an individual color channel. In this case, I'm going to start with magentas. In most images, the magenta color is not available, but in this case it is. If I drag the saturation up a little, then it works on the colors in the buggy. I'm also going to drag the lightness up a lot, because I want to lighten those magentas. Also, I want to lighten up the watering can. For that, I'm going to select the yellows channel and drag the lightness slider up also. Of course, the specific color adjustments that you do in your image are totally up to you. But using a hue saturation adjustment layer makes it very easy to adjust those individual colors. I now close the hue saturation window, and I'm ready with this color step, so I'm going to flatten the image. The next step is about playing with light. And of course, the lighter parts in your photo drag the viewer's attention to the places where you want them to be. In this case, I want to lighten up the little girl a bit. So I'm going to make a copy of my background layer with Command or Control J. Now I'm going to change the blending mode from normal to screen. And you can see that the whole image lightens up. Of course, that's not what we want. So I'm going to add a layer mask, pressing the Alt key. This fills my layer mask with black and effectively disables the lighter layer that I just added. Now I could select a brush and paint the light in, but I'm going to select the gradient tool. And in the toolbar options, I'm going to select the second option, which is the radial gradient. Now with my foreground color set to white, I just drag from the middle of this girl outward to add some light. I can do that again and again. So also in this leg, in this arm, and even in her face, I can add some more light. If I think the effect is too much, I can reduce the overall opacity a bit. In this case, I'm going to drag it down to about 3/4. Again, I'm ready with this step, so I'm going to flatten the image now. Our fifth step is about sharpening, and in this case, that's simple. We're going to apply the standard amount of sharpening, going into the filter menu, and here select Unsharp Mask. a value of 90%, radius of 1 pixel, and a threshold of 0 levels is OK, so I click OK now. This concludes our 5 steps for this photo. If you want to see what we started from, and I can show you, that was this photo, and in 5 easy steps, the result has gotten like this. Nothing really spectacular, but pretty nice nonetheless.